Check this out! ASRock has a Radeon 7900 XTX that is completely fanless. This is gonna be great for about 30 seconds. Then, it starts to thermal throttle dramatically.
Are you sure you don't want something with a fan on?
No. See, this was part of the plan. I have always wanted to take one of these server-oriented desktop cards with the no fans on them and hook it up to an air conditioner. Get it? AC-PC?
How in the hell is this gonna work?
I don't know. You're smart. You'll figure it out. Gosh, look at the time. I've got a meeting to get away to. Oh, and one more thing. While you're at it, can you remove all the other fans from the system? I want it completely silent.
Not so fast. If you've always wanted to try this, then you're helping out.
First, we're gonna take a closer look at the AC516S portable smart air conditioner from our sponsor for this video, Drio. It's a 14,000 BTU model, which is designed to cool up to 450 square feet. So it should be plenty for a couple square feet of computer with capacity to spare, meaning that when we're done, we will have built the first ever gaming PC that actively cools your room.
Well, this is nice and flat, so I think the easiest way to get the air to the PC is gonna be just some kind of shroud in a
sure.
pipe.
Sure, yeah, that's great.
Why don't we mock it up with this foam board?
I mean, I had something a little prettier in mind, but...
Well, we gotta make sure it works first, right?
Okay. Oh, did someone already do the work for me?
I did.
Wow! I thought you were gonna make me do the work today.
Well, you have to do some of the work.
Okay. Remember, kids, always cut toward yourself. That way you can see what you're doing. Okay. You can't get hit by a train if you see it coming. Don't worry, my balls already don't work anyway. Okay.
That's not bad.
Okay. Okay, well, she's not completely airtight, but she also doesn't need to be, and this should be good enough for us to get a quick test done.
You just want to see if air's gonna move, right?
Hey, not bad. Now, this could be a little restrictive. In a perfect world, we might want to step down the exhaust to a bigger circle, then step it down to our smaller one, but again, this is just proof of concept. We want to know if it's kind of going to work.
All right, how's that feel?
Glorious. There you go. Is that better?
Oh, that's beautiful.
Where are you exhausting this to? I mean, normally it would be a window.
The window right there.
Yeah, but that window doesn't open.
Why not?
Oh, yeah, that's how they work. Oh, my. Oh, not ideal. Okay. You're not really supposed to run a compressor sideways and then...
It was very brief.
That was not the... Oh my God. Did this seriously just like totally survive?
It's our best design ever, man, let me tell you.
Okay.
So what I'm thinking...
Yeah.
Go into the front here with like kind of a manifold and then we'd have shrouds on the things inside.
Oh, shrouds. Okay.
Like duct mod kind of idea.
Sure.
So we have one over the CPU.
Yeah.
Because you don't like this fan apparently.
Well, I kind of think we should start with the CPU fan being the CPU fan because this really doesn't feel like that much.
I pulled it out, so you know.
So we're putting this on the front.
To do this for now.
What?
See if it works.
Oh my God.
Fire it up. We just have to prove that it works and then we can make something good.
Have we done anything to make them believe that we will make something good?
I mean, we've got a lot of videos. They must believe something.
Yeah, there's been some good ones. Did it turn on?
Yep.
Somehow, everything still works. It's impressive how quiet the compressor is, hey?
The fans too actually are pretty silent, I'm surprised, even after dropping it.
They claim it runs at 46 decibels, which is pretty reasonable for a unit of this capacity. Now I noticed that the compressor is cycling pretty often.
That's on purpose.
Yeah, that makes sense for room air conditioning because you've got your thermal sensor going into the unit and it's going, okay, is our temperature good enough? It's not great for what we're doing where we might want 100% output all the time. We'll have to figure that out. Wow, our CPU is at 16 degrees and our GPU is at 33. Nice. Neither of them are doing anything yet though, so give us time, let us cook. And the CPU is up to 32 immediately.
Still cold exhaust.
You know what's the craziest part of this? Is that the cost of buying a window AC unit actually not that far off, like getting a custom water block system. Like, should we just be ducting chilled air into our systems?
Maybe.
Not necessarily. Spoiler, condensation can be a major issue when you are plumbing cold air directly into a warm environment, but we'll get to that later. So we're back to running smooth again. For how long, I don't know.
That coil wind though is, wow. Okay, GPU is getting pretty warm.
It's only at around 70 degrees still.
Okay.
The CPU is sitting at 27 though, which is perfectly reasonable for a gaming load. Hold on, it just dropped to 2050, 2020, 2000, 1990.
Oh, what did I do?
Good year.
So it's not perfect.
But we weren't expecting it to be. What we have found though, is that it's not dropping as low or as fast as when we were running without the duct. I want to see what we're going to land at. We're at 100 degrees on the GPU, which is obviously not ideal, but we're at 1500 megahertz. So while we're at the same temperature, we are running at 4x, 5x the clock speed?
Yeah.
That's a pretty big deal. We're settling in around 1400, and you can actually see a difference in the smoothness with the cool ducted air heading toward it. And that's not even blowing right through the heatsink yet. I think this is pretty promising. Let's put some more work into it. Now we're gonna switch over to the other AC unit that we did bad things to.
Okay.
Ah, so dots for 3D scanning.
Exactly, we 3D scanned the surface here.
Wicked smart. And that's to get a better seal against it, I assume?
Exactly.
Okay, let's have a look.
We also made a little tweak to this one. We took the thermistor, which usually lives inside the evaporator.
Right.
If that gets too cold, it turns off the compressor.
But we don't want that.
No, we want it to just keep running. So we just kind of stuck it out of the way and let it just run forever now.
Okay.
So we might get some condensation on the back, but we can deal with that later.
Yeah, normally this is like a condensation-free unit, right?
Yeah, they capture the liquid internally and recycle it and evaporate it.
Ooh, that's fancy.
Don't eat that.
I wasn't gonna eat it. Is there a reason we wanted it pointing down?
Because of the way the baffles work in there.
Okay.
They're kind of aiming this way.
Got it, makes sense. The main issue with our mock-up, though, was not getting the cold air off of the AC unit. It was getting that cold air plumbed up to our components. So that is where these shrouds come in.
So this goes on the outside.
Yes.
Air goes in.
Okay.
Air comes out of them, and we'll get into the components through those.
It's funny, because I've used air conditioners to cool PCs lots of times. It's just always been to chill coolant that I then pump through a water cooling system. I've never really just chilled an air-cooled computer. Well, I shouldn't say never. Like, I took that one outside to the NCIX parking lot 17 years ago or whatever, but see, how great is that low back force, huh? What? It's a good product.
We just can't stop you from shilling, can we?
Not shilling if it's a good product that you believe in. What the heck happened to this?
Okay, so we thought that this little guy here was the temperature sensor.
Right, that makes sense.
So we were blowing a hot air gun at it to try to make the thing run constantly.
Right.
Turns out that's the humidity sensor.
Right.
And also that's kind of melting.
Right. Whoa, that's awesome. We're gonna put that cold air right down the fins.
That'd be perfect.
I am a little concerned that the fin density on the GPU is a little bit higher than on the CPU. So there might be more back pressure and therefore we might get, oh my God, it's still really hot. We might get less flow through the GPU, but we're gonna have to see how it goes. We would never recommend putting this much strain on a 12 volt high power connector.
What could possibly go wrong with these connectors though?
Yeah, maybe just wrap it. Yeah, there we go. If you have an AC in your room anyway, what is a good reason not to do this?
I mean, this thing is what, 14,000 BTUs?
Yeah.
That's what, 4,000 watts, something like that?
Yeah, something like that.
So we can do way more cooling than we're gonna put out here.
Yeah.
Which means if our components get too cold and then warm up in the warm air, water can form on them and then everything's bad.
But it's possible, and we haven't tried this yet, it's possible that the system will work even when the AC is not running.
True.
So we could just have like, potentially, you could configure a system so that you have just normal operation and it just works off of your room's temperature like any other air conditioner would. But you could have like turbo mode and run the AC continuously if you wanna like, you know, I don't know, overclock. Oh dude, I can smell the flawless victory from here.
We could use an insulated hose here to try to keep a little bit more of the cool air in, but I think this is gonna work pretty well as it is.
Yeah, I think we're gonna be fine. And when we consider that the area we're trying to cool ultimately is the room, we don't really care if we have any losses of coolness into the room around us anyway.
As long as there's enough going to the PC, we're fine.
Yeah. There she goes. Not gonna lie, I'm still not feeling much out of that GPU, dude. We may need to put some kind of baffle or something in to make sure that we're not sending all of the airflow to the CPU. What Jordan's trying to demonstrate is that obviously if you were to set something like this up at home, which we're not necessarily recommending, you would want to have the AC unit itself farther away so that you get a noise benefit. And that's where something like an insulated duct would come in to make sure that it's still running at optimal efficiency while giving you that sweet, sweet silence. Of course, none of that's gonna be very useful if it doesn't work. Oh no. Jordan.
Yeah, buddy.
Our CPU is at 17 degrees.
That seems a little cool.
But our GPU is at 90.
Okay.
I think we need to put more baffle in.
Yeah.
The CPU needs like nothing.
Interesting.
Oh, this is so nice. Sorry, computer, I need this more than you right now. Now, you might have noticed something. We have the hot side blowing at the evaporator. That is to maybe, hopefully, help keep ice from forming on it?
Yeah.
Because we overrode the whole no condensation thing, remember that? I don't know if it's gonna work or not, but it's here. Oh, dude, we're down to 82. Oh, dude, I'm starting to get excited now. Okay, now this is getting cool. 80, we're at 80 now. 76, dude. Every single tiny gap that I plug, we are getting extra performance. Dude, she works awesome. And what's really cool is we're still throwing all this cold air out into our room.
Yeah.
The air coming off the GPU is actually pretty toasty.
A little warm.
I think we would need, like you said, to tweak the baffle system a little bit more. Or create a less turbulent path for the air into the GPU to try to focus it down there. Or even use a GPU that doesn't have such a tiny little heatsink on it. But overall, we're still getting cold air off of the back of the system.
Yeah.
Everything that's coming through the CPU is like freaking cold.
That's great, yeah.
So we're cooling our room and our PC, and we have no fans in this thing.
Well, power supply.
Okay, power supply fan.
Somebody stole the only good power supply with fanless. Stupid question.
Yeah.
Turn the computer this way.
Yes.
Make this go straight.
I was about to... We were on the same wavelength, Jordan. Same wavelength. Let's see if we can reduce our losses here a little bit. 76. Didn't really make a difference. What about moving it up? Let's get our path as direct as possible here.
Okay.
Ooh, I can feel more airflow off the GPU for sure.
There's a hand in my way.
Oh, sorry.
Yep.
It's still hot, but it's That's a lot moving. More. We're down to 74. And remember, we settled in around 76.
Yeah.
So let's see if we get a little bit more out of it here. This is getting a little damp now.
It's double walled, actually.
So you'd probably want to insulate the whole shebang. Actually, this especially.
Yeah.
Where you're going to get like condensation dripping off this in the longer term. 71, that's the lowest temp we've seen so far, though. So that's an interesting thought. So you'd want insulated lines.
Yep.
And then you'd probably want like an accelerator fan at a midpoint,
maybe,
in order to increase the pressure. Because this is not designed for high static pressure.
No, not at all.
This is designed to just throw cold air out into the room.
Blast it for your whole room.
Yep. So in order to overcome the losses from the tubing and from the fins, you'd probably want to add like an accelerator fan that's somewhat balanced with the output of this. But there's a ton of potential. Final temperature, a nice 69 degrees under load in Valheim, and all it cost us was the risk of condensation forming, which is gonna happen anytime you have a cold surface and warm air. So if we were to deploy something like this longer term, we would wanna put some kind of insulation on everything from our ducting to any 3D printed components, and especially on anywhere inside the system where cold air is going to be. But with that said, I don't think this is actually that wild of a concept for someone to do at home. If you're gonna have the AC anyway, look at these CPU temps. It's sitting at anywhere from 11 to 14 degrees in games, and this is, what did we have in here? A 12700K. That is flipping awesome. You don't have to use a Drio AC for this kind of shenanigans. In fact, I'm sure they'd probably prefer if you don't, you just use it to clean your room, but hey, massive shout out to them for sponsoring this video and letting us...
gently abuse their machines, maybe?
Yeah.
Not so gently.
They also sent over this room fan, which actually I was kind of impressed by. It's super quiet, and
super
I like the
quiet.
Way that it can oscillate in all kinds of
all
different directions. We're gonna have it and the AC unit linked in the video description, as well as a limited time discount, so you can find all the details down there. If you guys enjoyed this video, oh, why don't you check out the playlist? We have a Janky Cooling playlist with all the times we've done bizarre stuff like this.
This is one of them.